chipping about each other. That's a question.
Well, he's done this before. He loves the light.
You know, like, oh, he likes the light, like, yeah.
You have to be, you know.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, here at the Terry Griffiths Matchroom in Llanelli in Wales. And to those of you who are watching on the World Billiards YouTube channel, welcome to the final event here that we've had in two great days at the club. We're now ready for the final of the Welsh Open over 90 minutes. Your referee for the final will be Mr. Kevin Christie from Dublin, Ireland. And our two finalists, two great players of this great game, and if the standards that they set in the semi-finals is anything to go by, we are in for an absolute treat. Perhaps it might be cagier than both of the semi-finals, who knows. We've had some incredible play, a wonderful break of 588 from Dave Causier in his semi-final, and that's the high break of the tournament so far. So without further ado, please, let's make the players welcome. First of all, a man who really shouldn't be here at all because he phoned us at 8 o'clock this morning and thought that he would not be able to play. I'm not suggesting that what he ate last night gave him a dodgy tummy. However, he'd like to thank his sponsors, Imodium, for having him here in the final. Can you please welcome Mr. Peter Sheehan? And his opponent, all the way from Middlesbrough on a bit of a run. Wonderful semi-final, and he knows that's a match on now because Peter Sheehan is in great form, playing great, great billiards all weekend. The wonderful Mr. David Causier. So referee Kevin Christie will get the players to string, and then we'll be ready to start for the 90-minute final. Thank you.
Yellow. Partner three.
Okay.
second one. And 23.
6.
Two hundred.
3. So let me 5.
257. 7-2. 287. Three. Well. Two, 24. Forty. Seventy-five. Thank you.
1. 14.
Three.
9.
Dave Collier. Speaker Shane, the five. This Peter Shane two. Thank you. Sheen, 34. Six.
Thank you.
61.
Six.
Yep.
45. 47. 153. 155. 157. 159. 162. 164. 166. 168. 55. 171. 174. 177. 180. 183. 185. 187.
Can't tell my scoreboard either.
Scoreboard, yeah.
190. 192. 94. 97. 99. 204. 206. 2.19. 2.22. 25. 27. 2.30. 2. 2.34. 2.37. 2.39. 2.42. 2.44. 2.47. 2.49. 2.52. 2.54. 2.57. 2.60. 2.62. 2.64. 2.69. 2.74. 2.76. 2.78. 2.81. 2.83. 2.85. Miss, they've caused it 2.
10.
12.
14. 19.
24.
29.
34.
37. 39. 45. 47.
53.
55. 58. 60. 63. 65. 68. 71. 73. 76. 78. 81. 83. 86. 89. Peter Sheen, 89.
2.
Peter Sheen, five. Eight. Cards are up, credit two. Thank you. 27. 29. 32. 35. 37. 40. 42. 45. 47. Okay, pause here. 47.
2.
5. 8. 9.
Right.
11. 14. 15, 14. 2. 5. Okay, pause here. 5. 2. 15, 2. 3. 5. 7. 9. Okay, pause here. 9. Peter Sheen, 7. Cosier, 41. Great.
31.
Peter Sheen, 31.
Twenty-seven.
Fifty-seven.
6.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, a fantastic final here for the Welsh Open, the World Billiards Welsh Open at the Terry Griffiths Matchroom in Clonakilty. A couple of thank yous before we start. May I just say, on behalf of WBL, a huge thank you to the local players here who've been by far the most respectful players we've had during one of our competitions in an ordinary club, and we really do appreciate that. Thank you so much. There wasn't a sound to be heard, and it was really, really lovely. A huge thank you to our tournament director, Mr. Frank Bradley. Frank, great job as always. Many thanks.
Could I say one thing? Could I thank all the players? Because they've made this job a lot easier, and a lot of them are volunteers to referee, and it's very good, and it's all been played in the best spirit.
Absolutely, Frank. Thank you so much. And indeed, a big thank you to Sam Jones from the Yorkshire Project TYP, who has put on some fantastic streaming. We have the best of cameras now. We're even looking at being able to do slow motion replays, all of that kind of stuff. Although I think if we slow down Dave Causer, it'll still be at a breakneck speed. I don't know how that would work. A big thank you here also to Louise from the club, who has been single-handedly working through the weekend under difficult conditions with everybody wanting food. A big thank you to the referees. We'd of course Kevin Christie, who refereed the final, and to Steve Harrison, to Martin O'Reilly, and to Alex Dunn, and as Frank already mentioned, all of the volunteer referees who made such a big difference. Now, at our last tournament, when we came to the Challenge Cup, both players had left already. We're very grateful for the fact that our Challenge Cup finalists are here and they can accept their trophies. First of all, the runner-up, Mr. Chris Achilles. That you've never had anything quite like that in your life before. That's your runner-up trophy. Well done. And the winner of the Challenge Cup, will you please welcome all the way from the deep south of England, of course, it is, that's Steve Brookshaw. And so to the final, two great players who've been going head-to-head now over the last couple of tournaments and certainly getting to the end stages of all of the tournaments. And our runner-up, a gentleman I mentioned earlier on, it's incredible that he was able to stand up and play today, because to say he was dehydrated and not in great shape at 9 o'clock this morning would be just an underestimation of how sick he was. So we're absolutely thrilled. Will you please welcome our runner-up for the Welsh Cup? That is, of course, Mr. Peter Sheehan. Earlier on this morning, you didn't think that you'd be able to play.
No, I was going to follow that part.
But you played really, really well for the remainder of the tournament. I mean, you had a great day today up until the final.
No, me anyway, because I just had no press.
Well, congratulations. Well done to you. The runner-up, ladies and gentlemen, the Welsh Open, Mr. Peter Sheehan. And so, to the high break, by the way, a wonderful break of 588. As you know, there is a prize of £1,000 for a 1,000 break. And I was ringing the insurers earlier on because I thought he was certainly going to do it. It was very, very close. He was looking like he couldn't possibly lose. But the high break will be of 588 to Mr. David Causier. And to the winner, and picking up the Welsh Open champion trophy and this wonderful trophy here as well, will you please welcome Mr. David Causier. You to make a quick start in the final. You know how well Peter has been playing.
Yeah, I just thought if I could carry an early and put him under it, he might struggle to get back, but he played well. I thought he was going to put a real good challenge up halfway through, but it was never materialised for anything good.
How did you feel on that 588? How big do you think it could have got to?
I don't know, because I don't think I had about enough time. There's about 20 minutes left and everyone else is why don't you just make, like, give me it just for the effort.
No, I think if somebody gets the 1,000 break, we'll be happy to hand over the 1,000. So Dave, congratulations, you've had a great run, you played really, really well over the weekend, and well done. Ladies and gentlemen, the trophy winner, the champion for 2023 here at the next room next week, Mr. David Causier. That the closing date for the Belgian Open and the European Open is the 23rd of March. Is that correct, Chris? 22nd of March. We look forward to seeing you in the Trick Shots Club in Belgium. And also, don't forget that the World Match Play will be happening in Carlow in May as well. We look forward to seeing you there. But please do go online and you can register for the Belgian Open and for the European Open. And we look forward to seeing you there. Thank you to everybody who's made this weekend happen. Thank you here to the match room, to all the players, all the additional referees, all of the volunteers. We do our best to bring you the best in billiards, and you've witnessed two of the finest players in the world at the moment playing in that wonderful final. From all of us here in Wales, to those of you watching online, thank you so much, and we'll see you at the next tournament. Good night. God bless and mind you. Thank you. I was